Okay, good morning class. So this is for GE Electri or Philippine Popular Culture. So today is August 19, the 146th birth anniversary of the father of Philippine language, Manuel Luis Quezon. So I'm going to share some slides for you to be involved in the celebration of National Language and History Month. So I'm going to share the PowerPoint with you so that you'll be informed of what the celebration is all about. But more importantly, so this is our fourth meeting for Philippine Pop Culture. So this is the first slide. I hope you can see. So I'm going to have a slideshow. So again, good morning to our BAELS 2A students. But in hindsight, this is going to be the same video for the communication students who are taking up the same general education course, Philippine Popular Culture, and the social work students who are also taking up this GE Electri, okay, this semester 2024 to 2025. So this is the topic for today, so pop culture and overview. So this is based on the article by Tim Delaney at the online magazine Philosophy Now. So Tim Delaney is a sociologist, so perhaps the social work students would be able to relate more, but just the same, we are going to discuss this in relation to language and also to communication or media. So the presentation today is going to be composed of at least four parts. So one is the examples of popular culture, and regarding the distinction between folk and high culture, and the explanation of the sociologist to the formation of popular culture. And finally, Delaney pointed out some of the sources of pop culture. So let's dig in. So the article, Pop Culture and Overview, discusses several points. So let's begin with the premise of the article. So pop culture for the writer is generally recognized as the vernacular. So speaking of language, so it's a common language that can be understood by all. So moreover, this is the people's culture that predominates in a society at a given point in time. So about 100 years ago or more than 100 years. So Filipino is not yet a reality, it's just wikang pambansa. So in 1935, in the Commonwealth period, so the wikang pambansa was deliberated by several representatives in the region. So they decided to make Tagalog the pattern or the basis of the wikang pambansa before becoming Filipino. So in pop culture, to continue in the article, so Delaney cited Brumet, so in his book Rhetorical Dimensions of Popular Culture. So Brumet said that pop culture involves the aspects of social life most actively involved in by the public. So there's the idea of the public. So public like CR. So it's for everybody, for everyone. So in addition to that, according to the article, the products and forms of expression and identity that are frequently encountered or widely accepted, commonly like or approve, and characteristics of a particular society at a given time. So that's what pop culture is. So kung ano yung viral, ano yung sikat, ito yun yung popular. So dati, wala pang ganun. So ngayon ay meron na. So let's continue the overview. So, according to Ray Brown, as cited by Delaney, so in his article, Folklore to Popular. So, to quote, popular culture consists of the aspects of attitude, behavior, beliefs, customs, and tastes that define the people of any society. So, kahit saan daw, merong kultura, pero kung ano yung sikat na kultura, yun ang nagpapakita ng pagkakilanlan ng mga grupo ng tao sa lipunan na yun. So, what popular culture is, it's a identification. So, it's a tag, it's a mark among the people belonging to that particular culture or society. So, continue the overview. So, the next section is about examples of popular culture. So, this is just an enumeration. And during our previous meetings, we already had a discussion on this. So, one example is popular music. Another is print. Then, cyber culture or social media or the culture in the internet. So, sports. So, there are a lot of announcement in the MSEN's social media page about the tryout. So, be sure to try some of the sports that you are interested in. So, of course, we like entertainment. So, we like to be entertained all the time. And for what reason? Because there's leisure time or there's free time. So, we cannot be entertained if there's no free time or leisurely time. But of course, the result of this is that we are also fond of fads. So, yung mga nauuso, yung uso-uso lang ngayon, ano? Pero sa susunod ay malalaos din. So, hindi na siya kasing sikat kaysa dati. So, next is advertising. So, bakit ba siya popular? Kasi na-advertise. So, nabibigyan ng commercial o nabibigyan ng airtime o media mileage. Kasi napapanood din naman natin sa TV. So, to continue, the next section is about folk and high culture. So, ano ba yung folk? Ano? So, yun yung folk sa German, folk or Volkswagen. So, yun yung sasakyan, ano? Yung gumawa ng Beetle, yung ang tawag natin ay pagong na sasakyan. Luma na itsura pero classic, kaya hanggang ngayon meron. So, according to Delaney, folk culture represents a simpler lifestyle that is generally conservative, largely self-sufficient, and open. Characteristics of rural life. Folk culture is local in orientation and not commercial. So, parang ganyan sa Marinduque, ano? So, yung buhay isla. So, yun ang mabagal at hindi mabilis, pero ang kapalit nun ay hindi maulad, tsaka medyo mahirap. So, that's why kabaliktaran ng urban, yung rural, ano? So, yung buhay sa kabayanan, so hindi sa syudad o sa lungsod. So, continue. High culture, on the other hand, is not mass-produced nor meant for mass consumption. So, it belongs to the social elite, the fine arts, opera, theater, and high intellectualism are associated with upper training or reflection to be appreciated. So, hindi ito para sa lahat. Ano? Para lang ito sa mga may taste, yung may sophisticadong panlasa. So, bakit ba yung kuhul ay sikat na pagkain sa, ano, sa abroad, particular sa Pransya? Ano? Ang pangalan nun ay escargot. So, suso lang naman yun. Ano? Pero, yun, may taste yun na kakaiba, kaya enjoy nila. No? So, ilan ba sa atin na nakapunta sa opera? So, hindi ito yung opera na ano, social media browser. So, hindi ito yung opera na sa ospital. So, yung opera ay yung merong play, yung merong opera singer at kinakanta sa loob ng 3 oras at mahigit yung buong drama. No? So, medyo nakaantok. Sinubukan ko din yan pero di ko na natapos, nakatulog ako. So, marami pang ano, tungkol dyan. So, simply put, high culture is contrasted from folk culture. So, iba yung folk culture pang masa, yung high culture pang elite o yung pang mayaman, ano, yamanin, kumbaga. Okay, so to proceed. So, paano naman bubuo o nakakameron ng popular culture? So, in this section, the formation of popular culture, there are at least three things that the author pointed out. So, one is urbanization is a key ingredient in the formation of popular culture. So, people who once lived in homogeneous small villages or farms found themselves in crowded cities marked by great cultural diversity. So, ito yung sinasabi ko, parang university. So, kung naka-block section tayo ito sa mga bukid-bukid. So, pagdating natin sa Maynila, eh, hindi natin kilala yung mga kaklase natin kasi nasa urban tayo na lugar. So, sa Maynila din, meron industrialization. So, sabi ng author, it's brought with mass production, development and transportation such as steam locomotive and steamship, advancements in building technology, increased literacy, improvements in education and public health. So sa kung sa Pilipinas yan, so medyo malayo-layo pa, no? So imbis na tayo ay gumagawa na ng sasakyan o ng laptop o ng relo, eh bumibili lang tayo ng ano, ng buo na o yung galing sa ma-industrialized na mga bansa kasi meron silang technology doon. So tayo taga-bili lang o taga-konsumo ng mga produkto na to. So the third factor for Delaney is the emergence of efficient forms of commercial printing, representing the first step in the formation of a mass media. So kung nabalitaan nyo, ang UP, papalitan na yun, MassCom, ano? UP College of Mass Communication, gagawin na nilang College of Media and Communication. So hindi na mass communication, mass media dati. So like penny press, magazines, and pamphlets. So yun ang mga example ng mass media na sikat kasi nakikita ng lahat. So tuloy lang natin. So finally, we arrive at the last section about sources of popular culture. So one primary source is the mass media, especially popular music, film, television, radio, video games, books, and the internet. So kung bakit sikat na sikat yung mga kilala natin o bakit yung mga influencer, yung mga internet sensation ay dahil may mass media. Ngayon ay social media na yung mas popular. Ano? So popular culture is also influenced by professional entities that provide the public with information. Okay. So we got interrupted. Ano? Hindi lang pala sa record, sa hindi lang sa live, kundi pati sa recording ay meron din interruption. So doon tayo naputol sa primary source, which is mass media. Pero kinikilala din ng author yung mga professional entities that provide public with information. So ngayon, mga influencer na yan. So yan yung mga maraming mga followers. So these sources include the news media, scientific and scholarly publication, and quote-unquote expert opinion from people considered an authority in their field. So hindi na yan totoo ngayon kasi yung mga influencer na kahit hindi naman sila authority sa kanilang larang, eh mas pinapaniwala pa sila kaysa sa totoong expert. So tapos na yung panahon ng mga expert. Simula na yung panahon ng mga influencers. So speaking of which, so sana lang may mga influencer na nag-endorse nito ng celebration ng buwan ng wika. So this time, as mentioned during the orientation, August is for buwan ng wika ng pambansa, and this year the theme is Filipino Wika Mapagpalaya. And on the other hand, kasabay ng buwan ng wika ang buwan ng kasaysayan. So, ang tema ng buwan ng kasaysayan, according to the National Historical Commission of the Philippines, is salaysay ng bayan, saysay ng bansa. So, parang nasa biyahe tayo at ito yung mga signages and the jeepney that apply different routes, ano, including Marinduque. So, ito yung mga bayan-bayan natin sa buong bansa. Ano, so as an activity for the August month of language and history, so there's an celebration and there's an activity for both history and language month. So this is going to be carried over by the following week after the super long weekend in August 23 and August 26. So from August 27 to 30, so there would be several activities like book launches at in the Philippine, the Polytechnic University of the Philippines and the University of the Philippines in Diliman. So while I'm gone or I'm not around physically or in person, so in the Google Classroom, I'm going to post some assignment for you to be preoccupied in popular culture. So I'm going to encourage you to already begin your task regarding the island studies and creative hub. So for popular culture, I intend to have an output regarding the blurb. So what is a blurb? So it's the quotation or quotable quotes from the reader of certain books. So it's like a review of a movie. So it's not the full review. It's just the bits, the juicy bits. So the secret sauce. So later on, I'm going to ask for the full review, but you're going to undertake it as a group. So the blurb is individual and the review, the full book review is going to be undertaken by group. And so among the group, you're going to assemble your blurbs and come up with a coherent book review about the books that are going to be launched by August 27 and 28. So please keep posted for the announcement in the Google Classroom. Also, we came up with the social media community page. It's for the public. And so for those who are not aware and those who would not be able to come, so please do inform them so that they would download. So this is for free. So it's not pirated. So it's for everybody's consumption. All you need to do is have an interest. And so, of course, this is a requirement in class, but if you're interested, there are other books as well. So keep feeding your mind, not only your bellies. So please continue the learning process online or offline. So in person, also in the social media. So that would be all. Thank you and good morning once again.